But the thing is, if Russia was our friend, they would not have spent hundreds of billions of dollars modernizing their missiles, both short range and long range. They would not have maintained this large nuclear arsenal. Now, in the 90s, our priorities were a little bit different. We wanted to make sure this material didn't get to the Iranians. So we bought nuclear warheads from the Russians to be decommissioned to make sure it was done correctly. So up until 2 years ago, one of our largest sources for reactor fuel in the United States was an American company that had to deal with the Russians for the decommissioned strategic nukes under our arms treaties. But that doesn't apply to the tactical nukes.
And Michael, information. We only have about a minute more to our show. And you are so informative. I mean, you have really brought things that we people don't know these things, and I'm glad that's why we're having the show today, because I myself was not aware of all these
things.
We
need to be prepared for very real risks, that there are nuclear options that the Russians have, and in just like in the Cold War, we need to deter it so they know they would lose. And I think we need to focus on conventional forces, because we obviously don't want to escalate it beyond that, but we can't assume that Putin's too nice of a guy to ever think of using those type of options. He's not. I don't believe he is, unfortunately.
Well, I'm glad that you're able to come on the show today, because I think people need to be aware of this, that somehow it's not getting to us. I mean, we have a lot of television stations. We have a lot of news. We have a lot of cable news, our own Chicago news and news from, and we don't seem to get any of the same stuff that you talk about.
And the Europeans especially, because their military budgets are pathetic right now.
So I want to welcome you. I'm back to the show, and I welcome you to come back on the show, because I think what you have to say is really important, and it's something that we're getting here that we're not getting anywhere else. And that's why I have these shows, because I try to do shows that nobody else does. And again, I want to thank you, Michael Zanto, who's our foreign policy analyst, and he's talked about the Cold War, and welcome back. We'll have a lot more to talk about.
But not welcome back to the Cold War.
We don't want to welcome back the Cold War. I'm going to hope that
Thank you so much.
It works out. Thank you again.
We need to work to deter.